Alright, I'll represent. It's not much of a story, but I want to say about 3-4 years ago, I joined the ministry. It was like an evangelism ministry, and they were big on people using their gifts, and I didn't even know it. I wrote a poem and kept writing ever since. So this poem I did, honestly, I did it out of a response of a poem that I did, and my father happened to be there. He recorded it, showed it to the whole neighborhood, you know, Proud Dad and all that stuff. And I had people coming to me, and they was like, yo, it was dope, all that stuff. And I was thinking to myself, like, did you actually hear what I said, though? You know, like, I had a message, you know, I appreciate you thinking that it was dope, but did you hear what I had to say? So I wrote this poem in response. Once upon a time, I went to my people, and I spoke a word. I guess you could call it a spoken word. White faces, black faces, faces of all different colors. My platform was God. My tool was my skill. And my message was redemption and hope. But I had people asking, like, who am I and what does he do? I remember him when he was a little dude or back in high school, and he was kind of shy too. Now he's spitting sick verses like he got Ebola and the swine flu. And you know me, that's something that I would oblige to, but it's not just about me and my rhymes, dude. It's about truth, the truth, and the only truth. So help me God. So don't just get caught up in the rhyme scheme, but rather get an understanding of how my mind sees the divine plea about the divine seed, Jesus numero uno, the one that all of our lives need. I guess you could call this a rhyme plea. A plea to thee that we would take heed of our unrighteous deeds and see our need for the one who died on that tree that was carved out in the form of a lowercase t. Now hold up, I'm unrighteous too. You see, I already pointed the finger at me before I pointed it at you. And like Mr. T, I pity a fool, but it's hard to pity fools when I'm a fool too. But that doesn't mean I can't speak to Mr. T-R-U-T-H truth. And the truth is that this generation has been programmed to chase liquor and weed, sex, money, and greed. Men seeking attention from women by the way they be doing acts with no discretion. And women seeking attention from men by the way they be dressing with no discretion. And maybe that's because their daddies never gave them enough attention. And you see, we as men are confused, perpetually stuck in our youth. And that's probably because our fathers never infused our minds with truth. And maybe that's because they were never present like 0x2. Or like Santa didn't show up that Christmas night. And did I mention that nowadays our women be loving on women? And because we as men are broken and we reject the responsibility of our gender, supposed to be loving and cherished, but we reject it. Supposed to be protecting, but we running in the other direction. Supposed to be providing, but them dollars we hiding. Supposed to have a relationship with God, but we chasing facades. A false depiction. Do you get my perception as I paint for you this lyrical picture? And I know that might be a little descriptive and maybe even a little convicting, but to reach your heart. What about my sisters who lost their innocence within one incident? The moment you just wanted to be consoled deep within your soul, so you gave in to the first smooth-talking dude who said you were beautiful. And the sad thing is, he was only referring to your physical figure, and the smooth talk made the zipper go a little bit quicker. Now your predicament is lost innocence. And it's sad, but it's the truth, and you've been hiding it since your youth. While allowing it to abide in you, while spiritually dying like being locked in the phone booth, dialing 187, or more like 9/11, because when he floored in your life, your world came crashing down, and you traded your feelings of significance for feelings of insignificance. You know, insignificance only begets more insignificance. The point is, look, I know your soul's crying, but hear my soul crying for you to hear his soul crying. Not wanting one soul crying in that place where souls are crying. That place where you're dead, but you've never really been dying. And please don't be mistaken, because yes, Jesus came as the lamb slain, but the Bible says he's coming back as a lion. And there's no need for tigers and bears. But oh my God, if they only heard your heart's cry, that you were there, Lord, every time their hearts cry. Every time that person manipulated their minds just to get in between their thighs. Or every time that needle or pole got them high. Or every time the death left without saying goodbye. You were there, Lord, to hear their hearts cry. So as I cry, I pray that your heart will say hello to this truth instead of saying goodbye. That your lies will introduce this Christ, the one they call a Messiah. Be free from every single lie that told you were meant to crawl through the sins of life. For my God said, you were made to fly. So the point of it all is, Don't just make it about me and my talent, but truth be told, it's really about Jesus. And Jesus is God's all for you. It's through Jesus that God shows that he's mad and in love with you. This is true. So please, don't make it about me, but take heed to what you hear in my rhymes, please. Thank you.